Determine if the following series is convergent or divergent. We have the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of the difference of sine n and sine of the quantity n plus 1. This is an example of a telescoping series. A telescoping series is a series in which most of the terms simplify out or cancel in each of the partial sums, leaving only some of the first terms and some of the last terms. Which means to determine whether the telescoping series converges or diverges, we'll determine a formula for the partial sum s sub n, and then we'll take the limit of that as n approaches infinity. If the limit as n approaches infinity of s sub n exists, then the series converges, and we also know what it converges to. If the limit doesn't exist, then the infinite series diverges. Because we want the formula s sub n in terms of n, we'll consider the partial sum, but we'll replace the variable n with I, and let n be the upper limit of the index. So we have the sum from I equals 1 to n of a sub I, not a sub n, but notice it is the same formula. And now we'll expand. When I equals 1, we have sine 1 minus sine 2, plus when I equals 2, we have sine 2 minus sine 3, and so on. The last value of I is n, which gives us plus sine n minus sine of the quantity n plus 1. And now to analyze the partial sum. Notice we have a negative sine 2 in the first set of parentheses and a sine 2 in the next set of parentheses. Negative sine 2 plus sine 2 is 0. In the second set of parentheses, we have a negative sine 3. There would be a plus positive sine 3 from the next set of parentheses not shown when I equals 4. So the minus sine 3 also simplifies out. And then for the last set of parentheses, the positive sine n would simplify out with the previous set of parentheses, where we'd have a minus sine n when I is equal to n minus 1. So the sine n also simplifies out, but the minus sine of the quantity n plus 1 does not simplify out because it would take another set of parentheses to the right where we'd have a positive sine of the quantity n plus 1, but the upper limit for I is n, not n plus 1. So now we have a formula for the partial sum s sub n. S sub n equals sine 1 minus sine of the quantity n plus 1. And now to determine if the original infinite series converges or diverges, we'll determine the limit as n approaches infinity of this partial sum. So the original infinite series, if it exists, equals the limit as n approaches infinity of s sub n. And now to determine the limit as n approaches infinity, n plus 1 approaches infinity. But these are the input values for the sine function, and we know sine function values oscillate from negative 1 to positive 1. So because sine of the quantity n plus 1 oscillates in value from negative 1 to positive 1 as n approaches infinity, the limit does not exist because it's not approaching a particular value. And because the limit doesn't exist, we know the original infinite series is divergent. We could have also determined the original infinite series was divergent using the nth term divergence test shown here below. I hope you found this helpful.